Here we are, folks, Boston Logan International Airport, on our way to another adventure. Hey, everybody. Today we are coming to you from the Boston Logan International Airport, the new concourse over here, which is Concourse E. They have added this whole new wing to the airport. It's pretty fantastic. I'm just grabbing a quick bite and drink over here before we get on to our flight. We have a long haul, so our next stop will be Frankfurt, but that's not our end destination, so can't wait to show you where we land. Everybody, so I just wanted to show you this British Airways jet that's you got the two layers. I'll put what kind of jet it is below, but I thought that was pretty neat and wanted to just kind of show it to you. Hey everybody, so we made it to Frankfurt. We just have a layover here and then we're gonna go on to the next destination, which I can't wait to show you where that is. But this flight went well. It was about a 6 or 7 hour flight, almost 7 hours I believe. And we sat in economy, but it was like economy plus. So I'll put the name of it below. It was on Lufthansa. So I haven't flown with them for a few years, so it was nice to try them out again and see how their level of comfort has changed over the years. But we are going to wait here till our next flight, and I can't wait to show you where that's at. Alright folks, we are here and that destination is Portugal. We're actually starting our journey here in Porto, Portugal. And we're starting our day by going and walking around. We're going to see some historic stuff and likely taste some really good food. So, hope you enjoy the video. just went to the Timeout Market, grabbed a quick beverage, a wetter whistle. Now we're going to go and walk around Porto some more. Here we are right down by the water, just taking in the sights. It's a beautiful day. As you can see, all these restaurants behind us here. We're gonna sit down and grab something to eat. Catch you in a few.
So interesting that they have a gondola going over.
Right?
Wonder what the purpose is, you know? Yeah. Thank you.
You only find our product just here in the cellar, nowhere else outside. Okay, Quinta. In English, it's Farmer State and Corvo's the Cruise. All right, we got Anchor Port. 7 years white, 8 years dry. Totally filtered, no sediment inside, I don't taste anymore. You open, you got 3 years to drink it. That one, you can have with soft cheese, chocolate, charcuterie, barbecue.
Wait. Reserve bread. This is the 10-year-old red, and this is the 40-year-old red. And he said as the reds get older, they get lighter, which is the opposite of the weight. Mr.
So we decided to stop at this crappier place just towards our hotel a little bit. I'll give you kind of a panorama of the area. Super cute, super cool area, very, very student, kind of college-oriented area, but a great spot to watch the sunset. I don't know if I'll be here for that, but I will show you more of what we get into as the day moves on. All right, everybody, we're here at Musa, a wonderful craft beer spot, and they have some snacks, so we're going to indulge in some pig ears. So let me show you. This is a pig ear, and I'm about to try one. Here it goes. It's a pig ear. Very punchy. A little chewy, not terrible. Yeah, not too bad. Now, right. Fiona's turn.
Not what I thought a pig ear would look like. Can you hear me? Chewy.
How would you describe the flavor?
I've never had cartilage. That's what I envision it tastes like.
Hey everybody, so it is day number 3 here in Portugal for us. We had a full day of sightseeing yesterday, which was fantastic. Today we are just checking out a little bit late so we can go and enjoy the amenities here at this hotel. I'll show you a quick disaster view of our room. It's a pretty nice room. We have a pretty big shower in here. We have a bath and stand-up shower, obviously toilet. These windows open, we just have them shut right now. But this is a pretty neat, artsy hotel. Every room is named after a different artist. So that is the one that this room is named after. Pretty neat painting. But we're gonna go down, enjoy some of the amenities, like I said, maybe dip in the hot tub, and then come up, pack up, and head to the train station for the next destination. What a wonderful stay here. I'll put the name of the hotel below, but highly recommend it. And yeah, we're gonna gradually, slowly, but surely head back up to the room and get ready to head to the next destination. I'll take you along the way. Hey folks, here we are at the train station. I think it's San Benito, or I'll put it below. No, I'm butchering it. I think we're gonna head over here to the Timeout Market and maybe just grab a quick drink before we get on the train. And I'm excited to show you the train ride. Stay tuned. Train. Just gonna hop on. Showing you the toilet room. Looks pretty fancy. Sink. Looks like some paper towels. Cool blue light. And a toilet. Kind of small, but this is what you get. To Lisbon. We just got off the train. It's a pretty enjoyable train ride. Had a really good train experience. How's your train ride?
Yeah,
it was good. Yeah? But here is Lisbon and Campo train station. We're gonna try to figure out how to get to our hotel. Here's our room. It's a cute little hotel here. We have a double bed, a TV. There's Fee. And we have a really nice view out the window. I'll show you more of that later. We have a nice little bathroom. It's tiny but cozy. Hey. All right, folks, we gotta get cleaned up and make it to our dinner reservation, so. Check back in with you in a little bit. Just walking down the street on the way to our dinner destination, which is going to be really exciting. Fiona's taking a work call, so I thought I'd just go ahead and take a walk around the square here that's near our hotel room, and I'll show it to you. There's a little street market set up. Look at all these stalls set up. Yes, beverages, you can get snacks. Pretty cool. Here's a shot back towards the way we came. So we're just gonna walk around. We had a great night last night. Had traditional Thaido meal with music and singing, and then afterwards we went and explored and found some cool little wine bistros and really enjoyed ourselves. But over here you have all the food. something to see all these very local items and foods. I don't want to get crates of local. In the left. There you can see the castle. Hopefully we'll get up there later on. This is our hotel, so I'm just going to walk straight down and through that large arch down there. And this is Lisbon, Portugal, right here, you guys. Just heard that person we just passed are trying to sell marijuana, cocaine, hashish. Find that pretty commonplace in these larger cities, so it's a little disappointing, but hey, what are you gonna do? It's just there. Very typical Portugal day. It's overcast but sunny. Probably will rain shower a little bit. But then it'll pass and everything will be sunny again. It's It's a lot like Ireland in that way. It's kind of a little sprinkle or pour, but then it doesn't last very long. Pretty cool. Once again, tell you the name, huh? This huge plaza area here. You see the arc behind me? Arch, not arc. It's a big square. Thank you. hand over there. Somebody's likely inside of there, hoping that somebody will get their picture taken with them. I think I'm gonna head back and link back up with Fiona. She should be finishing up with her work stuff. And just wanted to really come down and see the water's edge, which we just did, so that was great. Probably be back down here later to show Fiona, since she hasn't been to Lisbon yet. And I have, but just kind of remembering all the good sights to see. I'm excited to explore more, so stay tuned. Babe in her happy place. Folks, we're in a tuk-tuk and we're gonna head to Castello di Giorgio, I think. I'm gonna put it below, but heading to the castle. Sounds like it really decimated the entire city.
I've read somewhere it's like 70% of the town is totally ground zero.
Wow.
Like a third of the population died that day.
Wow.
Because it's only in the summer, yeah, in the planted forest.
Wow. Yeah, that's so nice.
Entering the castle. It's all uphill. Gorgeous. Hey everybody, we're up here at the Castello, the castle on top of the hill. We were just on the other side of the city, took a tuk-tuk and made it all the way over here. But we are just grabbing a glass of wine and really just kicking back and watching the sunset, which is the best view in the city of a sunset in our opinion. So I'll show you that next on time-lapse. Good morning, everyone. We are in a taxi headed to the airport to pick up our rental car. And from there, we're going to head over to Sintra. And then from that point, we're going to head down to the Algarve. Algarve, how do you say it?
Algarve.
And we'll take you along the way. Here we are. We just checked into our car reservation. Fiona went to go get the key, and then I think we take one of these shuttle buses to pick up our rental car. We rented from National Rental Car because we've had really good success with them in the past, so we're kind of putting them to the test here on an international level since we've only rented from them while we were in the States. So far, the process has gone smooth despite the crying baby right there. But yeah, we're excited about going to the next place, which we're spending, like I said, I think earlier, that we're going to go to Sintra and explore around that area before we go down to the Algarve. And can't wait to show you what we get up to, so stay tuned. All right, folks, we got our little compact SUV, and we're headed off to Sintra. It's a manual, but that's okay, because I can drive manuals. But seemed pretty effortless for us to get the car. It took us, what would you say, about 20 minutes?
Yeah.
So far, so good. One thing to note, though, National Rent-A-Car and the Emerald Club, usually you can just pick the car up and go. This one, we actually had to pay a €1,000 deposit, which usually you don't see that. So curious why that happened, since I have Emerald Club status, but hey, no complaints. We got the car and we're on our way. All right, we've arrived in downtown Sintra, and we're just looking for some parking. We're going to check out the city a little bit and see what it's like. It's a very charming looking town, though. All right, after driving down some pretty squirrely roads, we finally made it. We're in kind of the downtown, we're in the downtown area up here. And we're gonna go walk around and see what there is to see. It's a cute town, though. Checked out Sintra and had a wonderful meal. I think we're gonna make another stop before we head down to the Algarve, where we're staying the night. But a wonderful time. I think we may even try to come back here on Monday just to poke around, but we'll see how our schedule goes. But cute, charming town. Definitely worth coming to visit. Just left Sintra a little bit ago, and now we're just passing Christ the Redeemer here back in Lisbon, and we're heading south. So we'll definitely show you some stuff along the way, but we're about 2.5 hours from the Algarve, and we're excited to be going. So can't wait to show you where we get up to. So we are here at Cabo de Roca, which is the furthest point in Portugal westward on the Atlantic Ocean. So we're going to be at the furthest point in Europe towards the United States and North America. furthest point in Europe you can get to the west. Checked in and I'll show you some more of what it looks like, but first impressions, it looks fantastic. Fiona went back to have them rescan the key, and then I'll show you what the key, show you what the room looks like. It's been a long day. Okay, here we go. Second time's a charm. There we go, that was a little confusing. Ooh, this looks gorgeous. Oh my gosh, very spacious. Wow, nice view. Out the window. Let's check out the bathrooms. Very cool. Also very big. Nice huge stand-up shower. This'll do. But as you can see, we're all cleaned up. We're gonna grab some food and just hang out and just enjoy this wonderful view behind us. Here's the view off the back of our resort. Pretty stunning. Some live music inside. All right, everybody. So we've decided to go to Lagos, which is about a 45-minute drive from here. We've heard it's a very quaint, charming seaside-type town, and we're going to go explore it. We're going to take you along with us. So stay tuned. First, we decided to come and check out this little beach spot and see what that's all about. So, we'll show it to you. Looks pretty nice, though. Beautiful day. Boardwalk here. It's really gorgeous over here. There's a little restaurant. There's other boardwalks with viewing platforms. We're gonna go out here and check out this platform.
See, see.
You wanna go down here first? Out there. How they got out there.
clear that water is down there. It's so beautiful. See the boats that will take you up into the caves. Anna's gonna touch the water. How was it?
Salads and carbonara coming, but it's a gorgeous day and just enjoying the view. Just walking around Lagos. We're going to go check out the Spanish fort, or the Spanish looking fort up here, and then make our way back to the place where we're staying. So should be pretty cool. I'll see if I can show you some of the inside. Everybody, so we have finished our meal and are back at our hotel. I'm just going to grab a nightcap and call it a night. And then we're back up to Porto, where we flew into. So we're going to have to go through Lisbon to get there, and I'll take you along on that journey. But for this video, we're going to end it here. I hope you liked it, and if you did, please hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and leave a comment. I'd love to answer any questions you guys have. But until the next time, safe travels.
rice and beans, sausages, and boiled eggs. Over here, where Fiona is, we have all sorts of light stuff, like fruits, meats and cheeses. Really good. Alright, I'm going to go there and enjoy some breakfast. Here's the outside of where we were staying. Absolutely gorgeous. Just going to go up to this peak up here, see if I can maybe get my drone in the air. It's pretty far down though, so I'm going to put my camera down and focus on the trail. But it's pretty amazing. Just walking up the hill here and admiring the views. This is a big hole. I guess it goes down to the ocean. I don't know if you can see that or not. But yeah, it's pretty nice up here. There's no railings. I think it's just a footpath that people have kind of carved out over the years going off the trail. But it's pretty awesome up here. You have boats coming in. You have boats going out to sea. You have sailboats out there. It's all pretty great. Good morning. Sorry. That's okay. So down here, you got the caves. All sorts of caves. You can see one of the boats down there right now. We're going to go up to this lookout spot over here and see what we can see. Fiona's back in the room, just sending a few emails, so I thought I'd take the time to kind of explore around. It's absolutely gorgeous. And I'll put the below the area where we're at in the Algarve, so you can thumbnail it or tack it onto your bucket list. But we also are creating a Google kind of map of places we've been, and we hope to make that available to you soon. But till then, just live vicariously through us. And if you do have the chance to explore over here in Portugal, hopefully some of our tips will be useful. But I'm gonna try to see where the point is. I think everybody kind of has a different place where they go out on this little perch. I don't want to go too far, but you see up the coastline there. It's absolutely gorgeous. As you can imagine, it's just a beautiful sea. Some more sandstone cliffs over there. The whole coast here is basically sandstone, so it's very crumbly and rocky, but there's some really cool paths that go along the top here. Again, not official paths, but one that I think people have created. And that's a shot of some of the plant life. All right, from here, gonna go back to the room and get packed up and start making our way to Lisbon. It's gonna be about a 3-hour car ride, but we have a great audiobook that we're listening to right now. I'll put it below. From there we catch a train. I think we have a late train at the moment, but we're gonna see if we can get that changed once we get to Portugal, once we get to Lisbon. I think we have a late train, but we're gonna see if we can change that to an earlier time once we get to Lisbon. So just admiring and soaking in this view before heading back north. Felt like it was a little bit cooler up in Porto than it was down here. Down here it's been absolutely perfect weather. People have been great, food's been fantastic. As you may have seen in one of our last videos, we went out to eat last night and it was fantastic. So we had some seafood last night, and we had some oysters and some other local seafood at this restaurant. And that's what we did. And today we're going to pack up and move out. So take you along the way. Thank you.
Hey everybody, so we decided to make a quick stop here in Silva to check out this amazing castle, which I will show you in just a moment. Oh yeah. Was it built?
Little is known about the origins. In 1189, the date of the first conquest of the city by Christian troops, it is known that this church was consecrated on the former main mosque, a situation that was repeated in the definitive conquest of this portion of the territory. The building that is preserved today is a Gothic reconstruction begun in the mid-13th century and whose completion dragged on extraordinarily.
Around the castle here. First there was the cathedral, and now we have the castle. Pretty neat. Thank you. what it's like to drive in Portugal. Tiny roads, not as bad as Ireland, but it's a challenge. Need to get a cab to the train station so we can catch our train up to Porto. It's a busy day here. All right, everybody, after an exhausting 3 hours of speed driving to try to make an earlier train, we were able to make one, not the original one we were hoping for, but one that's a little bit earlier than our last ticket. So we leave here around 5:05, headed back up to Porto. So we thought we'd take a rest. I'm exhausted. Fiona's kind of doing some exploring around. We're at the Orient train station here in Lisbon, and I'm lost for words because I'm so tired, but excited to get on the train and make our way back up to Porto. Now we're just waiting for our train to Porto. It's a cool route though. Everybody, we made it to Campagnana. That was a quick train ride, but we were pretty worn down from just a day of travel. Sorry. And we're going to take it one more stop, and then that'll be our end destination in Porto. From there, we'll go and get checked into our hotel and maybe jump out for a quick meal. But we're both feeling the travel day, but just glad we made it here in one piece. So stay tuned. All right, here we go. Getting on the train. All right, we made it back to Porto, so time to go get checked into our hotel and get cleaned up, maybe grab some dinner. And that's going to do it for today's vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, you know what to do. Hit that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. And leave us a comment if you have any questions. Until next time, safe travels. All right, everybody. We made it to Campagnana. That was a quick train ride, but we were pretty worn down from just a day of travel. Sorry. And we're going to take it one more stop, and then that'll be our end destination in Porto. From there, we'll go and get checked into our hotel and maybe jump out for a quick meal. But we're both feeling the travel day, but just glad we made it here in one piece. So stay tuned. All right, here we go. Getting on the train. All right, we made it back to Porto, so time to go get checked into our hotel and get cleaned up, maybe grab some dinner. All right, we're all checked in. Just gonna give you a room tour. It's a nice little room here. Got a nice large bathroom. That's a nice shower, toilet. There we are. All right, folks, we're going to get changed up and go out and grab some meat. Pretty happening area. This is our last morning in Portugal. We've just checked out of our last hotel. We're going to make our way to the airport. Another full day of travel ahead of us. So we got checked in to our flight and used our priority pass to grab a quick snack. We're going to be here for about an hour and a half, so just enjoying ourselves. We're waiting for our flight to Frankfurt and then from Frankfurt to Boston. Here's the things on offer. They have all sorts of snacks. Little sandwiches. There's tea. And there's the beverages. Here's the view from our lounge. Just playing a little Pac-Man in the airport. We're just killing some time here as we wait for our flight to start boarding. Be boarding our flight right now. Gate closes at 12:15 and it is 12:03 and the last passengers are still disembarking the plane that we'll be getting on to fly to Frankfurt. Just got a Google update saying the flight was delayed. I'm not sure how long. So we're just waiting. Waiting and waiting. That's our plane. All right, finally getting on our first leg. How are you feeling about it?
Good, ready to get on.
All right. And we're in Frankfurt. All right, after a really fast run to our departure gate here in Frankfurt, we are just making our return trip to Boston. So, here we go. Not a full flight. we're going to head to Castello di Jorge, I think. I'm going to put it below, but head to the castle. Here at Castello di Jorge, or I guess Castle of George.
Sure.
Sure. Don't know if that's right. Scan the key, and then I'll show you what the key, show you what the room looks like. It's been a long day.
You guys have about this area, the Algarve of Portugal.
We'll take a train back up to Porto where we'd be, where, damn it. Good morning, everybody, and good morning, everybody. We are here packing up our last morning here in the Algarve, and first, we'll be driving up to Lisbon. We're gonna see if we can get that changed once we get to Portugal, once we get to Lisbon. All right, everybody, so we made it to the last stop where we transfer to get on a train to go one stop to our end destination in Porto. So what's this one called? What's this stop called? All right, everybody, after an exhausting 3 hours of speed driving,